So just to let you know, I'm going to shape the truth, and I'm going to amplify everything that Action on Children does 10 times over every time I do a TV interview and talk to a national newspaper, until people who keep putting too much sugar in their food products recognise they're not going to get away with it. Right, so the army of lobbyists out there who are trying, and the spin doctors who are trying to tell me that you need sugar for energy and you've just got to get balance, it ain't going to work. So you better start thinking again, because we're coming back with more ambitious plans than we've had before in the past. That's the bad news. The good news is I actually want great partnerships and good ideas. And I've taken some risk in my own party. I've set up this commission, and thank you for mentioning, where I've asked a question that I'm not sure it's possible to get the answer to, because I'm not sure if it's possible to achieve this. Looking at the numbers on projected increase in type 2 diabetes and what we have to do to halt it, I've asked, can we halt the rise, and it's only the rise, in the lifetime of the Parliament? Because I think it requires ambitious thinking to get that step change that is necessary to change people's lives. And I'd like to work with you to see whether we can advance plans to reformulate food. How do we just get sugar out of the food economy, refined sugar, in a much more ambitious way? If there's anyone from Coca-Cola here, you're a disgrace. You shouldn't have 36 grams of Coca-Cola in a can of pop. It's more than the recommended daily allowance. It's not a bad choice. I think we poisoned our children. I don't accept it. And I'm going to be coming for Coca-Cola on their full fat sugar cancer pop as well. I think there are other suppliers. I did a thing in the Daily Mail today. If you buy a milkshake with 39 teaspoons of sugar in it, that's completely unacceptable. You can't moderate that. You can't spin your way out of that. You're poisoning our children. And when I was telling my daughter about it this morning, about this article in the Daily Mail, the first thing she wanted was a banana milkshake when we went to breakfast, because she'd seen the pictures of it in the paper. So I know there's a reverse psychology to this. Obviously, she was kind to her dad, and she didn't drink it. But that's the kind of things that I think just are unacceptable.